Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Life Science with KMD. Today I am going to explain about enzymes. Now the content which I am going to explain in this topic are chemistry of enzyme, classification, mechanism of enzyme action, kinetics, enzyme kinetics, inhibition, activation and specificity. Now enzymes are a biological catalyst that speed up the rate of biochemical reaction. Most enzymes are three-dimensional globular protein. Example, like it could be tertiary or quaternary structure. Some RNA species act as an enzyme, like in case of a ribozyme. Example is the hammerheaded ribozyme. Structure of a enzyme. Now this enzyme consists of an active site. Active site of an enzyme is the region that bind to the substrate, cofactor and prosthetic group and contain residue that helps to hold the substrate. Active site generally occupy less than total surface of the enzyme. Active site has specific shape due to quaternary structure of the protein. A change in the shape of the protein affect the change of affect the shape of the active site and function of the enzyme. Now the active site is further divided into two type, that is binding site and a catalytic site. In case of binding site, it choose the substrate and bind to active site, whereas the catalytic site, it perform the catalytic action of the enzyme. Now the cofactor is a non-protein molecule which carry out chemical reaction that cannot be performed by standard amino acid. Cofactor are two type, one is organic cofactor, another one is inorganic cofactor. Now if you see this protein, without a cofactor it is an inactive. If the cofactor will binds to the protein, it will activate the protein. Inorganic cofactor, these are inorganic molecules required for proper enzyme activity. Example is enzyme carbonic anhydrase requires zinc for its activity, whereas in case of hexokinase has a cofactor magnesium. Organic cofactor, these are organic molecules required for proper activity of enzymes. Example is glycogen phosphorylase requires the small organic molecule pyridoxal phosphate. Types of organic cofactor. There are two types. One is prosthetic group and another one is coenzyme. Now this prosthetic group are tightly bound organic cofactor. Example is flavin and heme. Whereas in case of coenzyme, these are loosely bound organic cofactor. Example is NAD plus group and biotin. Types of cofactor. An enzyme with its cofactor removed is designated as apoenzyme. The complete complex of protein with all necessary small organic molecules like metal ions and other component is termed as holoenzyme of holoprotein. Now what is a substrate? The reactant in biochemical reaction is termed as a substrate. When this substrate binds to the enzyme, it form a enzyme substrate complex. Now which is the site for enzyme synthesis? Enzymes are synthesized in the ribosomes, which are attached to the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Information for the synthesis of enzyme is carried by DNA. Amino acids are bounded together to form a specific enzyme according to the DNA codes. Intracellular and extracellular enzymes. Intracellular enzymes are synthesized and retained in the cells for the use of cell itself. They are not found, they are found in the cytoplasm, nucleus, mitochondria and chloroplast. Example is oxidoreductase catalyzes biological oxidation. Enzymes involved in reduction in mitochondria. These are all examples for intracellular enzymes. In case of extracellular enzymes, these are synthesized in the cells but secreted from the cell to the cell to work externally. Example is digestive enzymes, which are produced by pancreas, are not used by the cells of the pancreas but are transported to duodenum. Characteristics: enzymes speed up the reaction by lowering the activation energy of the reaction. Their presence does not affect nature and property of the end product. They are highly specific in their action, that is each enzyme can catalyze one kind of substrate. Small amount of enzyme can accelerate chemical reaction. Enzymes are sensitive to change in pH, temperature and substrate concentration. Turnover number is defined as the number of substrate molecule formed per minute by one enzyme molecule. Now, the nomenclature of enzyme. Enzymes are generally named according to the reaction they catalyzed or by suffixing "-as", after the name of substrate. The International Union of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology developed a nomenclature for enzymes. Each enzymes are described by a sequence of four number preceded by EC. EC denotes enzyme commission, and the number of enzyme is called as EC numbers. When classified, each enzyme is assigned by the EC number in the form of a digit separated by the periods. The first number categorizes the enzyme based on its reaction. Nomenclature: the first three number represent the class, subclass and subclass to which an enzyme belongs, and the fourth digit is a serial number to identify a particular enzyme within the subclass. The class, subclass and subclass provide additional information about the reaction classified. For example, in case of EC 1, 2, 3, 4, the digit indicate the enzyme is an oxidoreductase class 1, that it act on aldehyde or oxy group of donor subclass 2, that oxygen is an acceptor, that is subclass 3, and that it was the fourth enzyme classified in this subclass series number 4. The last printed list of enzyme appeared in the year 1992. Since then, it has been updated and maintained online. Enzymes are classified into 6 types. One is oxidoreductase, transferase, hydrolases, lyases, isomerases and ligases. So these are the 6 type. They are also, like, in case of oxidoreductase, the reaction type is reduction and oxidation. Example is lactate dehydrogenase. In case of transferase, the reaction type is moving the chemical group. Example is hexokinase. Whereas in case of hydrolases, here the reaction mainly takes place hydrolysis and bond cleavage with transfer of functional group of water. Example is lysozyme. Lyases, here the reaction type is non-hydrolytic bond cleavage, whereas in case of hydrolases, there will be a hydrolytic bond cleavage, whereas in case of lyases, it is a non-hydrolytic bond cleavage. Example is fumarase. Isomerase, it is usually used in case of isomerization, like intramolecular group transfer. Example is triose phosphate isomerase. Ligases, it is usually used by RNA polymerase, like for example, synthesis of a new covalent bond between substrate using ATP hydrolysis. So example is a RNA polymerase. Mechanism of enzyme action. The catalytic efficiency of the enzyme is explained by prospective of the two perspectives. One is thermodynamic changes, another one is processes at active site. Thermodynamic changes. All chemical reactions have an energy barrier between the reactant and the product. The difference between the transitional state and the substrate is called as activational barrier. Activation energy. All chemical reaction in a biological system have an energy barrier which prevent reaction from proceeding in an uncontrolled or spontaneous manner. The input of energy required to break this energy barrier or to start a reaction is called as activation energy. Enzyme lowering the activation energy of a reaction, that is required amount of energy needed for the reaction to occur, they do this by binding the substrate and holding it in a way that allow the reaction to happen more efficiently. See here, the activation energy of a catalyzed reaction, that means where here the enzyme was added, that's why it require very less activation energy was utilized here, whereas without an enzyme it require an high energy. So this is the difference between when we use an enzyme in a reaction and without an enzyme. Thermodynamic changes. Only few substances cross the activational barrier and change into product. That is why the rate of uncatalyzed reaction is much slower. The enzyme provide an alternate pathway for conversion of substrate into a product. Enzyme accelerate reaction rate by formation of transitional state having low activational energy. Hence, the reaction rate is increased many fold in presence of the enzyme. The total energy of the system remain the same and the equilibrium state is undisturbed. So coming to the process at active site, mainly the processes at the active site are covalent catalysis, acid-base catalysis, catalysis by proximity, catalysis by strain. Covalent catalysis. Enzyme form a covalent linkage with the substrate, forming a transition enzymes substrate complex with very low activation energy. Enzyme is released unaltered after completion of the reaction. See, in the initiation stage, the reactant binds to the active site of a specific enzyme in a specific orientation, forming an enzyme substrate complex. In the transition state facilitation, interaction between the enzyme and the substrate lower the activation energy required. Then at termination stage, the product have lower affinity for the active site and are released. Enzyme is unchanged after the reaction. Next is acid-base catalysis, mostly undertaken by oxidoreductase enzyme, mostly at the active site where the histidine is present, which act as both proton donor and a proton acceptor. Catalysis by proximity. In this catalysis, molecule must come in bond forming distance. When enzyme binds, a region of high substrate concentration is produced at active site. This orients substrate molecule especially in a position ideal for them. Catalysis by bond straining, mostly by lyases. Here the enzyme substrate binding cause reorientation of the structure of the site due to strain condition. This transitional state is required and here the bond is unstable, eventually broken. In this way, the bond between the substrate is broken and converted into a product. Fischer's lock and key model, also known as a template model, proposed by Fischer in the year 1898. The union between the substrate and the enzyme takes place at the active site, more or less in a manner in which a key fits a lock, and as a result the formation of the enzyme substrate complex. In fact, the enzyme substrate reunion or the union depend on reciprocal fit between the molecular structure of the enzyme and the substrate, and as the two molecules are involved, like that of the substrate and the enzyme involved. The hypothesis is also known as concept of intermolecular fit. The enzyme and the substrate complex is highly unstable, and almost immediately this complex decomposes to produce a product, end product of the reaction, and to regenerate a free energy. The enzyme substrate reunion result in release of energy. It is this energy which in fact rise the energy level of the substrate, thus inducing activated state. This activated state, certain bonds of the substrate molecule become more susceptible to cleavage. Induced fit model. More recently, studies have revealed that the process is much more likely to involve an induced fit model proposed by Daniel Koshland in 1958. According to this, exposure of the enzyme to the substrate caused the change in the enzyme, which caused active site to change its shape, allow the enzyme and substrate to bind. The enzyme or the reactant change their shape slightly. The reactant become bound to the enzyme by weak chemical bond. This binding can weaken bonds within the reactants themselves, allowing the reaction to proceed more readily. Now in this picture, you can see that two substrate molecules are drawn into the cleft of the enzyme. The enzyme changes its shape, forcing the substrate molecule to combine. Then the resulting end product is released by the enzyme, which returns to its normal shape. Now after releasing the end product, the enzyme will return to its normal shape, ready to undergo more reaction. Enzyme kinetics. The quantitative measurement of the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction and systematic study of factors that affect this rate helps in analysis, diagnosis, treatment of the enzymatic imbalance that underlie numerous human diseases. Level of particular enzyme serves as a clinical indicator for pathogenesis, like myocardial infarction, prostate cancer, damage to the liver. Enzyme kinetics. Any biochemical reaction constitute in which A plus B will give rise to C plus D, where A and B are the substrate and C and D are the products. The study of enzyme kinetics has two components, that is Gibbs free energy, which indicates the direction and equilibrium state of the substrate and product, activation energy, mechanism of reaction and the rate of the reaction. Gibbs free energy change, that is delta G, also called ether free energy or Gibbs energy. It describes the quantitative form, both direction in which the chemical reaction will tend to proceed and the concentration of substrate and the product that will be present at equilibrium. Mathematically, delta G is equal to delta Gp minus delta Gs, where delta Gp is the sum of free energy of formation of reaction product, whereas minus delta G is the sum of free energy of formation of substrate. The sign and the magnitude of the free energy change determine how far the reaction will proceed. If delta G is negative, then the reaction proceeds in the forward direction and it is spontaneous. Activation energy. Any reaction does not proceed directly to product formation. There is always a transition state between the ground state and the product. Activation state or activation energy, the difference between the energy level of the ground state and the transition state. The function of catalyst is to increase the rate of the reaction. It does not affect the reaction equilibrium. So, enzyme just lower the activation energy. Factors affecting the enzyme activity. The contact between the enzyme and the substrate is most essential prerequisite for enzyme activity. The important factor that influence the enzyme reaction are concentration of substrate, concentration of enzyme, temperature, pH, product concentration, activators, time, light and radiation. Concentration of substrate. The frequency with which molecules collide is directly proportional to their concentration. The sum of the molar ratio of the reactants defines the kinetic order of the reaction. Michaelis and Menten hypothesis. Michaelis and Menten in the year 1931, while studying the hydrolysis of sucrose catalyzed by enzyme invertase, proposed this theory. This theory is, however, based on the following assumption. A single substrate and a single product is involved. The process proceeds essentially to completion. The concentration of substrate is much greater than the enzyme in the system. The intermediate enzyme-substrate complex is formed. The rate of decomposition of the substrate is proportional to the concentration of enzyme-substrate complex. Michaelis-Menten hypothesis. According to this theory, postulate that enzyme form a weak bonded complex with the substrate. This enzyme-substrate complex on hydrolysis decompose to yield a reaction product and a free energy. Now this is Michaelis-Menten equation. According to this equation, V is equal to V max into S divided by Km plus S, where V is the velocity or the speed of the reaction. V max is the maximum enzyme maximum velocity in converting the substrate to a product at saturation, and S is the substrate concentration, and whereas Km is the Michaelis-Menten constant, which represent the substrate at half the Vmax. Now if you take this graph, here x-axis represent the substrate concentration, y-axis represent velocity of the velocity of the reaction or the speed of the reaction. And if you can see that at a particular, after a particular period of time, the enzyme velocity will be at stationary phase after attaining a maximum, maximum velocity of the reaction. The enzyme will get into a stationary phase, which represent Vmax, that is maximum velocity of the reaction. So if we take an substrate at half the Vmax, this is the velocity of the reaction at maximum, then if we take the half of it, that is half the Vmax, and draw a line in the graph, then it will intersect at the x-axis, which represent Km. So Km is substrate concentration at half the Vmax. So the concept of this hypothesis is to define the affinity of the enzyme for substrate. Michaelis-Menten hypothesis is also known as Haldane's constant. Km is a constant and a characteristic feature of a given enzyme, like for example strength of the enzyme substrate complex. Lower the Km value indicate a strong affinity between the enzyme and the substrate. Majority of the enzyme Km value will be 10 to the power of minus 5 to 10 to the power of minus 2. So this can be used, Km can be used, this hypothesis can be used to calculate the Km after experimentally determine the reaction rate at various substrate concentration. This equilibrium constant, that is Km, when V is equal to half the V max, Km is numerically equal to the substrate concentration, or in other words, Km is equal to the concentration of substrate, which gives half the numerical maximum velocity. It is noteworthy that any enzyme substrate system, Km has a characteristic value which is independent of enzyme substrate concentration. Significance of Km and Vmax value. Km is used to measure the enzyme's affinity for its substrate. Lower the Km value, higher the enzyme affinity for substrate and vice versa. Km value also provide an idea of the strength of binding of substrate to the enzyme molecule. Lower the Km value, the more tightly bound the substrate is to the enzyme for the reaction to be catalyzed and vice versa. Km value indicate lowest concentration of substrate the enzyme can recognize before reaction catalysis can occur. The enzyme's Km describe the substrate concentration at which the half of the enzyme's active site are occupied by substrate. Km value is also used to measure the substrate concentration when the reaction rate maximum velocity of 50%, that is Km is equal to substrate at half Vmax. The maximum rate reveals the turnover number of an enzyme, the number of substrate molecule being catalyzed per second. This varies considerably from 10 in case of lysozyme to 6 lakh in case of carbonic anhydrase. Concentration of enzyme. Reaction velocity is directly proportional to the concentration of enzyme. Serum enzyme for diagnosis of disease, known volume of serum and substrate taken at optimum pH and temperature. Enzyme is assayed in the laboratory. Temperature. The velocity of enzyme reaction increases with increase in temperature up to a maximum and then decline. Increase in temperature causes increase the kinetic energy of the molecule. A bell-shaped curve is usually observed. Temperature coefficient Q10 increase in enzyme velocity when the temperature is increased by 10 degrees centigrade. Optimum temperature for most of the enzyme is 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. Beyond 50 degrees centigrade, there is a denaturation of enzyme. Next is pH. The most intracellular enzyme exhibit optimal activity at pH value between 6 to 8. Balance between enzyme denaturation at high or low pH and effect on the charged state of enzyme, the substrate, or both. Exception like pepsin, the pH range will be from 1 to 2. Acid phosphatase, pH range is between 4 to 5. And in case of alkaline phosphatase, the pH range, the optimum pH range should be between 10 to 11. Activators. Certain metallic cations like magnesium, manganese, zinc, calcium, cobalt, copper, nickel and potassium. It act in various way, like in combining with the substrate or formation of enzyme substrate metal complex, directly participation in the reaction and bringing a conformational change in the enzyme. There are two categories of enzyme requiring metals for their activity. One is metal activated enzyme, not tightly held by enzyme and can be exchanged easily. Example ATPase, where it required magnesium and calcium and enolase. Another one is metalloenzyme, hold the metal tightly. Example here the metal will be held tightly. Example is alcohol dehydrogenase, carbonic anhydrase, alkaline phosphatase, carboxypeptidase. Other factors like product concentration, even if there is an accumulation of reaction products, generally decrease the enzyme velocity. Next is light and radiation. Exposure to UV ray or a beta ray or a gamma ray or even an X-ray will lead to the inactivation of certain enzymes, like for example formation of peroxides, or even when you expose a UV ray inhibits salivary amylase activity. So these are all some of the examples. Pharmaceutical importance. Enzymes are virtually involved in all physiological processes, which make them the target of choice for drugs that cure or ameliorate human diseases. Applied enzyme kinetics represent the principal tool by which scientists identify and characterize therapeutic agents that selectively inhibit the rate of specific enzymes catalyzed processes. Enzyme kinetics thus play a critical role in drug discovery as well as elaborating the mode of action of drugs. Lineweaver-Brook plot. It is also called as a double reciprocal plot because this is it is just like Michaelis-Menten plot, but it will be in a reciprocal manner. It is used to find out Km and Vmax. It is used to determine enzyme internary or ping pong form, and it is used to determine how enzyme is inhibited. So this plot will be used for the detection of how enzyme will be inhibited, or in the determination of ternary or ping pong form. Sometimes the enzyme can bind to two substrate at a time. That type of reaction involves in the formation of a ternary complex, where first substrate will bind to the enzyme and another second substrate also bind to the enzyme to form a ternary complex. Now this ternary complex is further divided into two forms. One is ordered random order, and another one is ordered form. In case of random ordered ternary complex, the enzyme can bind to the first substrate, or it can bind to the second substrate first. Like S1, here the enzyme can bind to the S1 first or S2, that is substrate 2 first. There is no order in this to produce a ternary complex. Whereas in case of ordered form or ordered ternary complex, there should be a order in which the enzyme will bind. Like first S1 should has to bind, and next when it form a enzyme substrate complex, then later the second substrate, that is S2, will bind to that to form a ternary complex. So these are the two forms. One is ordered random ordered ternary complex, and another one is ordered ternary complex. Next is ping pong complex, or a double displacement complex, in which the enzyme with no ternary complex is formed. That means, see here, enzyme with the first product and a secondary product will give a ternary complex. Here also, in random ordered and ordered, enzyme with two products are present. Whereas in case of a ping pong or double displacement, what happens is that enzyme will bind with the first substrate, produce an enzyme substrate complex, and then that will lead to a first product. Now this first product will be replaced, and then the second substrate will bind to that enzyme to form an enzyme substrate complex, which led to the second product. So So in this way, it will displacement of the first product will takes place. After that only second substrate will bind to the enzyme. So these are the two types of reaction which can takes place. So how the plot, reverse plot will be, inverse plot will be seen in case of ternary complex. We see the interception in this place, and the reciprocal plot will be in this form. Whereas in case of a ping pong, parallel lines will be seen. No interception will be seen in this. So this is the difference between the ternary complex and a ping pong complex or a double displacement complex. Inhibition, prevention of an enzyme process as a result of interaction of inhibitor with the enzyme. Inhibitors are any substance that can diminish the velocity of the enzyme catalyzed reaction is called as inhibitor. Types of inhibition. Inhibition can be divided into two types. One is reversible and another one is irreversible. Now this reversible is further divided into four type. One is competitive, uncompetitive, mixed, and the fourth one is non-competitive. Reversible inhibition. It is an inhibition of enzyme activity in which the inhibiting molecule entity can associate and dissociate from the protein's binding site. In case of a competitive inhibitor, in this type of inhibition, the inhibitor will compete with the substrate for the active site. Formation of the enzyme substrate complex is reduced while a new enzyme inhibitor complex is formed. Example for competitive inhibition is statin drug such as Lepiter compete for HMG-CoA substrate and inhibit the activity of HMG-CoA reductase that bring about the catalysis of cholesterol synthesis. Now this is how the competitive inhibition plot look like, where you can see the y-intercept. This will be a reciprocal, same as the Michaelis-Menten plot, but in a reciprocal, but it will be in a reciprocal form. And if you see the formula also, it will be the inverse of Michaelis-Menten equation, where this formula will be in the form of y is equal to mx plus b. So in the same way, if we take the inverse of Michaelis-Menten equation, what happens is 1 by V naught is equal to alpha Km by V max into 1 by substrate, 1 by S plus 1 by V max. So this is the formula for competitive inhibition. So what we have to remember is the intercept at the y-axis. And this formula you should have to remember this. Uncompetitive inhibitor. This type of inhibition, in this type of inhibition, the inhibitor does not compete with the substrate for the active site. Instead, it will bind to another site known as allosteric site. Drug to treat cases of poison by methanol or ethylene glycol act as uncompetitive inhibitors. Examples are tetramethylene sulfoxide or 3-butyl thiolin 1 oxide or uncompetitive inhibitor of liver alcohol dehydrogenase. So if we see the reciprocal plot of uncompetitive inhibitor, we see a parallel line instead of a y-intercept, which was seen in competitive inhibitors. Whereas in case of uncompetitive inhibitors, we see the parallel lines, and formula also will changes. That is 1 by V naught is equal to Km by V max into 1 by S plus alpha by V max. So this is the formula for uncompetitive inhibition. Mixed inhibition. In this type of inhibition, both enzyme inhibitor complex and enzyme substrate inhibition complex are formed. Both complexes are catalytically inactive. So this is the reverse, this is the inverse plot of mixed inhibition, where interception is seen here instead of a y-axis. So what we see, the plot is in this manner, and even the formula also changes, where 1 by V naught is equal to alpha Km by V max into 1 by substrate plus alpha prime by V max. So this is the formula for mixed inhibition. In case of non-competitive inhibition, it is a special case of inhibition. In this inhibition, inhibitor has the same affinity for either enzyme or enzyme substrate complex. So that is called as a non-competitive inhibition. Irreversible inhibition. This type of inhibition involves the covalent attachment of the inhibitor to the enzyme. The catalytic activity of the enzyme is completely lost. It can only be restored by synthesizing the molecule. Example is aspirin, which targets the covalently modified key enzyme involved in inflammation, is an irreversible inhibitor. Suicide inhibition. It is an unusual type of irreversible inhibition, where the enzyme converts the inhibitor into a reactive form in its active site. Activation. Activation is defined as a conversion, as the conversion of an inactive form of enzyme to active form, which processes the metabolic activity. Types of activation. Activation by cofactor. Conversion of an enzyme precursor. These are the two types of activation. One is activation by cofactor, and second one is conversion of an enzyme precursor. Activation by cofactor. Many enzymes are activated by cofactors. Example is DNA polymerase is a holoenzyme that catalyzes the polymerization of deoxyribonucleotide into a DNA strand. It uses magnesium ion for catalytic activity. Horse liver dehydrogenase use zinc ion for its activation. Conversion of an enzyme precursor. Specific proteolysis is common method of activating enzyme and other protein in biological system. Example, the generation of trypsin from trypsinogen lead to activation of other zymogens. Enzyme specificity. Enzymes are highly specific in nature, interacting with one or few substrate and catalyzing only one type of chemical reaction. Substrate specificity is due to complete fitting of active site and substrate. Example is oxidoreductase do not catalyze hydrolase reaction, and hydrolase do not catalyze reaction involving oxidation and reduction. Types of enzyme specificity. Enzymes show different degree of specificity. One is bond specificity, group specificity, absolute specificity, optical stereo specificity, and dual specificity. Bond specificity. In this type, the enzyme act on substrate that are similar in structure and contain same type of bond. Example is amylase, which act on alpha 1,4 beta glycosidic bond in starch, dextrin glycogen, and glycogen, shows a bond specificity. So the amylase, which act on alpha 1,4 glycoside bond in starch, dextrin, and glycogen, show a bond specificity. Group specificity. This type of specificity, the enzyme is specific not only to the type of bond but also to the structure surrounding it. Example is pepsin. Pepsin is a endopeptidase enzyme that hydrolyzes the central peptide bond in which the amino group belonging to aromatic amino acid, example is phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan. Optical stereo specificity. In this type of specificity, the enzyme is not specific to substrate but also to its optical configuration. The D amino acid oxidase act on D amino acid. Then L amino acid oxidase act on L amino acid. There are two types of dual specificity. The enzyme may act on one substrate by two different reaction type. Isocitrate dehydrogenase enzyme act on isocitrate one substrate by oxidation followed by decarboxylation, two different reaction type. Dual specificity. The enzyme act on two substrate by one reaction type. One is example is xanthine oxidase enzyme act on xanthine and hypoxanthine, which are two substrate by oxidation one reaction type. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.